Welcome to the 8th grade moving up ceremony. Please remain standing for America the Beautiful.
Good morning. I would like to welcome the members of the Board of Education, Dr. Mustick, Dr. Ferraro, and Dr. Lutinski, and members of the administration. Independence is something that we all have to face at some point, but to face it at too young of an age can be difficult. I remember when I was 5 years old and I was talking to my mom about where I wanted to go when I was older, and she said, "One day you're going to want to spread your wings and fly." And I said, "Well, I'll spread my wings and fly around the backyard." But as the years have passed, I've grown up and realized that maybe at some point, spreading my wings isn't quite as out of the realm of possibility as it once seemed. Though daunting at times, I believe that independence is something that can be reached with years of support from the people that are most important to us. In my experiences in middle school, I've always had the help and guidance of others, and I think this is incredibly important. I've never really been one to admit that I need it, but a lot of times, accepting help from others is entirely necessary. When we allow ourselves to rely on others, we create bonds of friendship and trust that can never be broken. These bonds are essential to success and happiness. I could not have gotten through middle school without the people I love. I face problems I have with those that are there for me, because the people we surround ourselves with define who we are. Each friend and family member I have is like an arm or a leg. And would any of us leave one of those behind? Independence is something we all long for from a very young age. In Bellows, we dreamed of the freedom, as we called it, that came with the transition to middle school. We looked forward to being able to choose whether we wanted to go on the playground or stay inside, and deciding whether to take part in school sports or clubs. However, while everyone is eager for independence and growing up, when the time actually comes, it's terrifying. We try to jump into being adults, not realizing what that entails. With independence comes immense responsibility that is difficult to handle. I myself am someone who is constantly trying to grow up 3 times too fast, but always find myself back where I started. There is a reason we have teachers, friends, family, and everyone else in our lives. We need them. We try to become independent and break away at such an age when we are too young, and then realize that we are not ready for it. We get stuck in this position, too ashamed to admit that we actually do need help. But why be ashamed? The only way to become independent is to accept what we have done, ask for the help we need, and learn from it. If we collect the knowledge of our mistakes, it is inevitable that one day we will no longer need to constantly rely on others. That day will never come if we deny to ourselves that we are in need of other people. When we overlook the fact that the road to independence is one full of helping hands, we get caught at a dead end. I've been traveling on that road for a very long time, and I've run into many dead ends, but eventually I will find a new path to take. In my years of middle school, I've come closer and closer to becoming independent, and I've had my family, friends, and teachers with me every step of the way. As of now, I can't tell you what exactly it's like to be independent, but each year in middle school has made me a stronger person. I look forward to one day being able to face the world by myself, but I have time to get there. After all, what's high school for?
My pleasure to introduce Dr. Mustick, Superintendent of Schools.
Thank you, and what an impossible act to follow. Wasn't that amazing? Welcome, middle school graduates, to this event that marks one of the most significant transitions for our students. It is a celebration of success, a time to reflect on our past accomplishments. It's a time to look forward to the exciting years of high school, and it is a day we come together to honor our graduates, their parents, teachers, for all of their hard work and dedication. Recently, I had the opportunity to hear Ken Burns, that noted historian and filmmaker, speak. Mr. Burns is completing a book, a work on a new documentary called The Address. It's about students in a small school in Vermont. As part of their graduation, all of the students must memorize and then present the Gettysburg Address to their classmates and parents. It was strange when I first saw it, but when we saw the film clip, it made sense. The Gettysburg Address is not a very long speech, but it has a lot of complexity. Lincoln delivered it during the American Civil War in 1863. Just 87 years after the founding of our nation. This was one of the most tenuous times for our nation, and it could have marked the end of our nation, but Lincoln's words served to inspire and unite our divided people. Lincoln chose his words wisely, a good lesson for all of us. In just over 2 minutes, Lincoln reiterated the principles of human equality, espoused by the Declaration of Independence, and proclaimed the Civil War as a struggle for the preservation of the Union, separated by the secession crisis. With a new birth of freedom that would bring true equality to all citizens, Lincoln also redefined the Civil War as a struggle, not just for the Union, but also for the principle of human equality. Truly, it's about finding the inner strength to push through. We talk about this as grit, setting a goal and sticking to it. What better advice for middle schooler students as they move into the high school? There are indeed many lessons in the words of this famous speech, and actually in the film itself. As we watch the students struggling to memorize the speech for the presentation, we see how individuals, students, meet and exceed a particular challenge. We witness tenacity, hard work, determination, all key to student success. As well, it is thought that Lincoln's words will serve to remind the students of the importance of tolerance and acceptance, and to embrace diversity to create a stronger, more united nation. The documentary is slated to commemorate the 150th anniversary of the Gettysburg Address on November 19th, with a national TV broadcast tentatively planned for next spring. There's going to be a challenge to all Americans to learn and relearn this address, a mass memorization. Burns said he thinks the 150th anniversary is the opportunity for all Americans to revisit Lincoln's message in the darkest days of the Civil War, not only to be reminded of the events, but to celebrate the human spirit and rise as a nation from the ashes to this war. He will challenge each American to try to memorize the Gettysburg Address, and we're hoping it will be among the greatest mass memorizations in history, he says. Today, I've given each graduate a copy of that speech to hold on for until next year, with the hope that it will serve as both a reminder for you today as you move on to the high school, and a reminder in life about what's important and what you need to do. Congratulations to the class of 2013.
Please welcome Dr. Lipinski, principal of middle school.
Good morning. When we write speeches, we have usually a goal or a realization for the target audience in mind. And after listening to Claire's speech, I think our eighth grade, my target audience in this case, probably a lot closer to achieving those goals and realizations than sometimes we realize. When Ms. Tolan told me that this year's graduation theme was independence, I thought, that's easy. I was a history teacher once. George Washington, don't tread on me. No taxation, I can do that. But Mr. Magnani, Mr. Becker have already covered that with you guys, so I was forced to really consider the word independence as it pertains to soon-to-be ex-eighth graders. Independence sounds great. Of course, it's a political principle we believe in. We declare independence. We name cities and aircraft carriers after it. We have a day off in July to celebrate it. Our Bill of Rights is a list of freedoms from the constraints that others may put on us. Rousing words by Thomas Paine in Common Sense and Mel Gibson at the end of Braveheart tell us what we know. Independence is a good thing. The word itself means freedom from control or support. However, the opposite of independence is dependence. The variable here is perspective, because dependence can also be good. Independence Hall was not only the place where Jefferson's Declaration was debated, but in that same place, just a few years later, we created a government of dependence, each branch dependent on the other two for checks and balances, our leaders dependent on the vote of the people, and the people dependent on each other for contributions to military service and tax revenue. We learned early that there would be no American cultural progress without an acceptance of some level of dependence. The Civil War was a contrast between the insulated South and the interdependent North, and the winner was clear. So which do you want? Independence? To be a free thinker? An independent learner to be self-motivated? Or dependence? To work and play well with others? To be a team player? Or by definition, to be dependable. Those are all the kind of comments that mom and dad like to see on report cards, and there are certainly words that you will find in your college recommendation letters. But which are you? And if you are one, can you be the other? Are independence and dependence at odds? The answer, my friends, is blowing in the wind, meaning if it were so simple, we wouldn't be talking about it. I believe you need balance. I think it's unrealistic to say you want to be independent from control, but not from support. You can't have your cake and eat it too. Childhood is a wonderful time of independent achievements. At some point, you learn to sit up, crawl, and put Cheerios in your mouth. This is followed by shoe tying and talking. My favorite as a parent is when my kids could go in and out of that restaurant bathroom stall on their own. At Rhinebeck, it was probably the first time you walked or rode your bike to school. Middle school is probably not much different. It may have been the time of your first sleepover, the first time you were able to stay home alone, or when you got a cell phone. And the next 4 years will be the same. You have a lot of special milestones to look forward to during your time at Rhinebeck High School. You'll choose your own electives, learn how to drive a car, get around on your own.
decide who, if anyone, you go to the prom with, and eventually choose a college or career path. But dependence is not simply a nostalgic list of ways you cease being dependent on someone else. Growing up is learning how and when to be dependent on others, and therefore, how to be responsibly independent. So that's my point. You need to be responsibly independent. Independence as we know it is not freedom to do what you want when you want to do it. One of the key responsibilities that comes with independence is realizing that you do not live in a vacuum. We have networks of people to whom we are tethered to varying degrees. First, siblings and parents, then friends and teachers, and finally people you work with, and maybe your in-laws. Examples of this can be found everywhere. A movie just came out about Jackie Robinson called 42. In one scene, Robinson asked team owner Branch Rickey, "You want a player with the guts to fight back?" And Rickey replied, "No, I want a player with the guts not to fight back." With freedom to play in a white league and the financial independence that came with a good contract, what made Robinson successful was how he handled his independence. With what Robinson faced, anyone could have fought back with angry words or violence. But he made a choice and recognized that his role was one of restraint, professionalism, and dignity. His dependence, which included his family and his teammates, and all African Americans at that point in our history, were dependent on him to prove a stereotype wrong and break a barrier. They couldn't make him act in a certain way, but it was his responsibility to do so. Maybe you won't wind up as the subject of the movie, or maybe you will. But you have been and will be faced with the same kinds of challenges. For example, if you don't do your homework, several things can happen. Every zero that you accumulate increases the chances that a teacher has to stop lesson planning and email your parents. At that point, your parents may have to reply, get on your case, and create anxiety at home. Then your parents might have to come in, be late for work, attend the meeting, and you can see where this leads. Lack of responsible independence causes others to have to clean up your mess. When you're with your group of friends and there's a possibility you're about to do something a little shady, something you probably wouldn't do on your own, have the guts to be responsibly independent and don't do it. Even tougher, when you see one of your friends is about to take the wrong path, have the independence enough to recognize your codependence and be more than a bystander. As you get older, you learn that you can't claim independence and then blame others when things go wrong. When you get to the other end of the building in September, celebrate your new level of freedom by being truly independent. Avoid being swayed by the group while still considering how you fit within your network of people. Responsible independence by you is the key to all of our success. Thank you.
We would like to honor the 8th graders for their accomplishments this year, so I'd like to invite Mr. Seglia and the 8th grade teachers up to the stage, please. Going to present the three sport awards. Allison Abatantono. Henry Bruno. Louis Caroline. Nick DeLuca. Aaron Drace. Ian Gabriel, Peter Gallagher, Jessica Giordano, Alex Cuddy, Timmy Kelly, Canetta, Michael Colorado, Kevin Wimmers, Ryan Reyes, Christina Shin, Ben Styler, and Jack Van Buren. Excellence in English goes to Kiara O'Day. Achievement in English as a second language goes to Jean-Baptiste Langlois. Excellence in Regents Algebra, Emily Crook. Excellence in Math 8, Nathaniel Langlois. Excellence in Regents Biology, Robbie Alter. Excellence in Science 8, Henry Wang. Excellence in Social Studies, Hunter Greenhill. Excellence in French, non-native speaker, Crystal Finkenberg. Excellence in Italian, native speaker, Reed Peterson. Excellence in Italian, non-native speaker, Caitlin Tan. Excellence in Spanish, native speaker, Luisa Tito. Excellence in Spanish, non-native speaker, Pierre Clerc. Excellence in Art, Benjamin Banker. Outstanding musician in band, Amber Yang. Outstanding contribution in band, Anthony DeRose. Outstanding contribution in strings, Robbie Alter. Outstanding achievement in theater arts, Sydney Cameron. Outstanding performance in theater arts, Bria McLean. Most consistent effort, Cameron Sullivan. Most improved throughout middle school, Anthony DeRose. You present a few more now, please. High honor roll for all of 7th and 8th grade, Emily Crook, Reed Peterson, and
Fraser Shaw. Overall academic excellence, Fraser Shaw. Principal's Award for Character, Lainey Jones. Dr. Mustick, will you present some awards for us too, please? The American Association of University Women Math and Science Award, Emily Crook. Congressional Certificates of Merit for Academic Achievement, Allison Abitantono. Martha Andrioli. Philip Beebe. Allison Cohen. Jillian Hurlbut. Nadia Main. Corey Parker. Michael Cotteraro. Christina Shin. And Dan Styler. The Attorney General's Triple C Award for Character, Courage, and Commitment, Stephen Saputo. And our final award, the State of New York Comptroller's Award for Academic Excellence and Civic Commitment, Fraser Shaw. Thank you, Dr. Mustick. Teachers, you can go back to your seats.
Mahatma Gandhi once said, "We must be the change we wish to see in the world." He was definitely right. I'm going to make this simple. We are all capable of being independent, every single one of us. We all have challenges in life, problems in life, friends and enemies in life. The list goes on and on. But the simple truth is now we are becoming more independent than ever. High school is definitely a workload, from what I've heard. We're prepared for it, or at least I think we are. Not only will we be piling essays, projects, books, and homework on our back, but a great load of independence and responsibility as well. We will have to get our work done in the right way and at the right time. And we'll try not to be late to gym too, considering the fact we have to walk what feels like miles and miles just to get there. But what Gandhi said relates to everyone, no matter what one might think. The world appears to be getting significantly worse every day, with wars, natural disasters, oil drilling, global warming. Once again, the list goes on and on. Then we start to think, what happens when the world runs out of resources? What happens when we no longer have a renewable amount of food that we like to eat? What happens when we can't use our brains because of material items we've become obsessed and possessed over? We need to be the generation to fix this. We need to be the generation to take a stand and right the world's wrongs. but we have to make sure that we do it without relying solely on technology. Someone once said, "I fear the day that technology will surpass our human interaction. The world will have a generation of idiots." Sadly, this is already happening. About a month ago or so, I went to the famous Mamaroneck Diner with my family. I looked to the left and saw two friends who had gone to the diner together. They both had their iPhones down on the table and were not looking at or even talking to one another. They just kept scrolling through their addictive devices. Like this, like that, favorite this, favorite that, tweet this, retweet that. When people are in a bad situation and the first thing they do is take out their iPhone, they don't realize it also turns off your brain. It seems like we rarely use our brains to do anything. We need to use our independence to break away from technology and use our brains again. Seriously, is it really necessary to take out your phone to update your profile in the middle of a family dinner? And am I the only one who doesn't have the new Samsung Galaxy 2.0 ultra-fast 4G Razr? These new phone names sound like that annoying lady in front of you at Starbucks. Sure, technology can be great, but sometimes at the cost of our independent thinking. Independence is real. Responsibility is a choice. We won't always have teachers reminding us about doing homework or a project. We have to be responsible to do these things, to turn in assignments on time, stay on top of classwork and homework, and get extra help from a teacher if we need it. The point is, we have to learn how to do our own work in our own way without constantly having reminders about it. We need to be independent about it. This is just one of the many steps to ensure that we'll be the change we wish to see in the world. We will need to be independent about many things because soon the world will be relying on our generation. People sometimes say, "What's the point of me doing something if no one else does?" But there is a point. Take responsibility and do whatever needs to be done. No matter what anyone says, a small change can really make a big difference. When we face failures in the future, and the younger generation will look up to us and ask us to do something about it, what are we going to do? Ask Siri? No. We need to be motivated and be proactive to prevent people, including us, from making bad decisions to help the world stay on its feet. If we can learn this, then we can pass it on to our children. Hopefully, in 100 years, the world will be a better place. But that depends on us doing the right thing, even if it requires standing up and putting differences aside to get the job done, so we can pass it on to future generations. If we expect to be the change we wish to see in the world, we need to take on more responsibility, allowing us to be more independent about doing the right thing. If we want to avoid being a generation of idiots with technology that can surpass our intelligence, we need to use our independence to break away from this. And this is the perfect time to start. As we end our middle school career and begin our high school one, let's not forget that the choices we make today will affect the outcome of tomorrow. Congratulations to the Rhinet graduating class of 2017.
Before we're done, a quick review of your year of fun. Notebooks, pens, and pencils galore, 6th and 7th complete, you were ready for more. You came to us in early September, eager to learn, do you remember? You quietly sat, poised to learn. You patiently waited for your next term. You struggled a bit with the transition, but settled on succeeding, it was your mission. An early field trip to Hansel and Gretel, then we pushed harder to test your mettle. Your minds expanded with each new lesson. X was the factor that became your obsession. With dates and numbers and definitions to master, the end of second quarter came even faster. You strained and strived for more success. You were gaining independence, more or less. With each new class, we opened your minds to exciting ideas and brand new finds. No longer did you sit quietly in your seat. You were on the go, kept us on our feet. Questions you asked every chance you could. We encouraged thinking, help you grow, we knew it would. The harder you worked, the more success you found. Suddenly we were trying to keep your feet on the ground. As spring arrived, so did the dreaded state test. You worked your hardest, did your best. Independence, what better place to have it tossed in than your thrilling eighth grade trip to Boston. Faneuil Trail, Harvard, Faneuil Hall, Fenway Park, Duck Tour, you saw it all. You returned with the warning it would end soon. The next thing we knew, it was June. Use your best judgment, your teachers implored. Sometimes you did, we were floored. Let's not forget the time your teachers put in. To not thank them would be a sin. Your parents too, always there for support, watching your concerts, cheering your sport. The lessons you learned, more precious than gold. Don't push youth away, for soon you'll grow old. Make sure you speak up whenever it's needed. Otherwise, you'll find yourself unnecessarily defeated. Remember, it is essential to keep an open mind and not set on fire every wrong thought you find. You've grown this year, some to astounding heights, and it is your time to shine in the lights. Now you are ready for the high school scene. Good luck to the class of 2017. Dr. Luchinsky will now present the certificates. Allison Abatantona. David Aguilar. Gabriel Ajram. Robert Alter. Marco Andrioli. Benjamin Banker. Jesse Barreto. Cameron Beach. Philip Beebe. Jack Barucha. Lisa Bianco. Maria Bianco. Hallie Bruno. Gabriella Cajas. Samantha Calderon. Sydney Cameron. Gabriella Carducci. Jack Carducci. Luigi Carolini. Matthew Castellucci. Russell Castor. Christian Cepoloni. Nicole Chimlecki. Mary Cintron. Allison Cohen. Benjamin Colantonio. Matthew Collado. Donald Cornelius. Grace Cozy. Emily Crook. Katie Plato. Louis DeSantis. Alex DeLitta. Sarah Director. Anthony DeRose. Nicholas DeRico. I would like to invite Danny Warren teacher Dawn Drace to the stage to come present her certificate to her daughter. Erin Drace. Van Dyke. Frankie Escalon. Jake Fagan. Jack Evans. Jake Fagan. Crystal Finkenberg. Kyle Fox. Ian Gabriel. Luis Galliano. Peter Gallagher. Lizbeth Garcia. Daniel Garofalo. Jessica Giordano. Maria Gladstein. Peter Greenberg. Jillian Hobart. Helena Jones. Claire Julian. Alexander Kebby. Timothy Kelly. Helena Keyes. Gregory Klunk. Jean-Baptiste Langlois. Nathaniel Langlois. Matthew Lawham. Madeline Leeds. Jesse Leveron. Cole Lewis. Catherine Mercredo. Jacqueline Longbucko. Alyssa Lucino. Gabriella Murphy. Giovanni Murphy. Victoria Manilover. Nicole Manzella. Rhea McLean. Davidson Mead. Isaac Meyer. John Moore. Lizette Morales. Elijah Morton. Nadia Naeem. Marissa Nakagama. Owen Michelski. Kiara O'Day. Andrew O'Hanlon. Cosimo Panetta. Corey Parker. Maxwell Pasquina. I would like to ask middle school teacher Craig Peterson to present his son with his certificate. I would like to ask middle school teacher Eileen Pillick to present her daughter. J.C. Pillick. Debbie Crone. Matthew Ponticello. Cole Redding. Kevin Reimers. Ryan Reyes. Nathan Sanchez. Steven Zapito. Rachel Shaw. Christina Shin. Carly Sonnenclair. Luna Soto. Logan Spencer. Emma Steenkamp. Justin Sturgis. Benjamin Styler. Cameron Sullivan. Kayleen Tan. Joseph Tardio. Jose Taneo. Luisa Tito. Jack Van Buren. Danilo Vasquez. Elizabeth Fioli. Victoria Fioli. Wang. Molly Wiener. Ellie Williams. Rachel Wurzberger. Amber Yang. Nicholas Yurgo. Gabriel Zangiacomi.
Dr. Ferraro, I present to you the Rhinelander High School graduating class of 2017.
Please stand while the class of 2013 exits the auditorium.